It's a safe assumption that one of House Speaker Paul D. Ryan's, our Wisconsin, least favorite parts of his job is to have to contradict President Trump. Ryan has maintained he will speak out when he disagrees with Trump, but he also frequently goes out of his way to avoid those conflicts, such as claiming he hasn't seen Trump's latest controversial tweet. Ryan's strategy makes sense. Trump is the person who signed Republicans' tax bill into law in December, after all. So it's notable that not even Ryan can defend Trump's performance in Helsinki on Monday alongside Russian President Vladimir Putin. Within hours of that stunning news conference, where Trump wouldn't say he believes you, S intelligence chiefs over Putin about Russia meddling in the 2016 election, Ryan was out with this statement. In short, Ryan thinks Trump got it wrong on Russia. Very wrong. Trump was too lenient on Putin and too quick to equivocate on Russia's hacking of Democrats and targeted social media advertising. Ryan seems most concerned that Trump showed absolute unwillingness to hold Russia accountable for trying to influence the outcome of a sovereign nation's election. This is all happening 4 months before another election in the United States that has voting officials and politicians worried about potential Russian hacking. As Ryan points out in his statement, even Trump's own allies in Congress, who have been willing to go to great lengths to defend Trump and undermine the special counsel Russia investigation, don't question that Russia meddled in the U.S. election. When House Republicans ended their investigation into Russia's meddling in April, they said they don't think Trump helped, and they made the controversial judgment that Russia didn't interfere specifically to help Trump. But even they didn't and don't dispute that Russia tried to intervene in the U.S. election. Intelligence experts have concluded Russia did it specifically to help Trump win. The timing of Ryan's statement is notable too. The last time Ryan confronted Trump in such a clear manner was last summer, when Trump blamed both sides for white supremacy-led violence in Charlottesville. Ryan wrote a Facebook post saying in part, "We all need to make clear there is no moral relativism when it comes to neo-Nazis," bolding the part about moral relativism. But Ryan's implicit condemnation of Trump's actions came 9 days after the protests in Charlottesville and 6 days after Trump blamed both sides. In a CNN town hall that evening, Ryan made it clear he wouldn't do more beyond the 500-word TSK Facebook post, which didn't even mention Trump by name. At the time, Mitt Romney and other GOP leaders had said the president should apologize. By contrast, Ryan's much quicker statement on Russia left no nuance on where he stands, in total disagreement with Trump's performance. As Ryan prepares to leave politics at the end of this year, he's given us no reason to think he'll become the next GOP anti-Trumper. As I wrote in April, when Ryan announced his retirement, that still appears to be the case. And that's why it's remarkable that Ryan said what he said Monday about Trump and Putin. It's clear that Ryan not only thinks Trump got it wrong on his approach to Putin, but Ryan is worried Trump won't stand up to Russia going forward. Very worried.